Hey, welcome back to A-Aron Reacts. I'm back for only my second. Amira Willighagen. I'm not entirely sure the pronunciation reaction. I think I learned it, but it's been too long since I've done Amira. And in all honesty, I kind of forgot, but here I am again. And we'll certainly do more of her. But I think this one is more recent. And I did her way back when she was nine, I think. And this is Down From His Glory, and it seems like this is a duet, I'm guessing. Amira Willighagen featuring David Cerna, and I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing his name correctly either, but let's get right to it. Okay, I didn't even think about it. I don't know if this is her original or what, but in any case, with the clouds and down from his glory, I'm guessing it's a religious song, you know, maybe from the perspective of God. It's just my guess going in, but we'll see. Okay, it looks like it's by her. Wow, so weird to see her all grown up.
Down from his glory, ever living story,
Beautiful.
my God and Savior came, and
Yeah.
Jesus was his name. Born in a manger to his own.
Wow. Okay, first of all, David sounded fantastic. And musically, there's a number of surprising movement with the melody and the chords. It's a slight bit off what you expect to hear. It shifts a couple times, and you hear that with David and with her. I love David's eye contact, and he just sounds great from the beginning. I th actually thought we were going to get less operatic song from his singing originally, and the moment she opened her mouth, I had instant shivers all over my whole body. I mean, the sound just unbelievable. And I thought we were going right into an opera at that point, but I just realized that that is just her background and her understanding, which I also learned way back then that she was self-taught from videos, I believe, if I recall correctly. It was a little while back. But she just sounds fantastic, and I love her smile. She's in her place, she's in her zone, she's so happy.
In him, thus the su gloria, oh, che bella
Oh.
storia, bajo el rey de amor, Jesús el buen pastor, nació el pesebre.
So I think in typical operatic fashion, it's in Italian, I believe. Gosh, just beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I mean, really.
Through
It was such brilliant arrangement on top of their beautiful singing, right? She sings something, he sings it. She sings it, he sings it. She sings it, he sings it. I think they did that four times, if I'm not mistaken. She sung it, then he took it down an octave, and then they go right into some harmonies. Just beautiful. Their transitions are smooth. I mean, this is perfection. And they're clearly very comfortable together. Now, they're recording separately. I don't know if they're, doing it live together or what. It's not clear to me. I didn't read any notes. I don't see any kind of monitor for him. It must be on the other ear. He must have a single ear monitor. That whole transition was, I think, completely a cappella, and just to change it up rhythmically, tonally, and that harmony together was just pristine. Beautiful. Okay, I don't know enough about opera to know if it's, or even not even a vocalist. So, it's just my personal preference. And it could be the first time they're performing together, and that's obviously very difficult, if not impossible, to do for first time, especially if they haven't rehearsed much. I don't know any of this stuff, right? All that aside, I would have liked to see them or heard them match their vibratos more at the ending. They didn't quite do that. And if I heard correctly, which I may not have, I think he was slightly behind her on the attack on that belt. Beautiful. Yeah, I don't think they're going to match vibratos. I think her vibrato was m much smaller, and his is more wide. So, in any case, that was just beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I think any of my critiques are not even critiques. Like, there's just, I mean, it's just a preference, I think, of what my ear wants to hear. But I don't even think there's, I think it's probably even a choice to not care. And that's okay. Oh, it's so cool to see her grown up. I kind of wondered what she would sound like and look like. It looks just like her. I've only seen her once, but excuse me. And I don't know who David is. Clearly he's opera background, because we really didn't hear a lot of it throughout, or at least from my perspective. I mean, some of the tone for sure. Obviously, classically trained and very disciplined singer, no doubt about it. But we definitely heard the opera background from him at the end with that belt for sure. Awesome. What do you recommend I listen to next from her, or should I check out more of David? If you haven't yet subscribed, please go ahead and do so now. We will see you in the next one. Thank you.